So we're taking a look at the practice 4.7 through 4.8 quiz. This first problem has you taking a look at the discriminant, which is going to be b squared minus 4 times a times c. Your b term here is 10, so you're squaring 10. You're subtracting 4 times a, which is 5, where c is 5. So this arithmetic is going to say 100 minus this product, which is eventually 100 minus 100, which is 0. So your discriminant here is 0, since this is a discriminant that's equal to 0, we can say that there's only one real solution. This is mentioned in the outline. Anytime the discriminant's equal to 0, there's only one solution. So although we could solve this with quadratic formula, you'll notice if you look very, very closely, this is definitely a trinomial that can be factored using Diamond method. If you're not convinced, try it out. You would have a product of 18. Your sum is negative 9, negative 6, and negative 3 work here. So you could solve this as x minus 6 with x minus 3. This all equals 0. So you could just say really that x equals 3 and 6. Move on with it. No need to really use quadratic formula here. That's just a mirage. With the next problem, you do have to get all three terms on the same side. I know the arithmetic here can be tricky, so make sure you distribute first. This will give you 8x squared plus 2x equals 9. But keep in mind, you want all three terms on the same side, so rewrite this. 8x squared plus 2x minus 9 equals 0. If you then go for quadratic formula, you end up with negative 2 plus or minus the square root b squared, which is 4, minus 4 times 8 times c, which is negative 9. And this is all over 2a, so all over 4. Sorry, 16. So we have 16 in our denominator seen here. First fraction you could rewrite as just negative 1 over 8, and then plus or minus what eventually could be the square root of 73 over 8. And this is after you simplify the arithmetic in here, you can factor out 4, and then you can rewrite 2 over 16 as denominator 8. So this would be your answer. For the next one, this is asking pretty much how many solutions we would have. You have a few options with this. You could just evaluate what the discriminant is. So that's option one. Or you could just picture this. I mean, the y-intercept's positive 4, so it's going to have to be up here when you graph, and it's opening upwards. So just based off of these two facts, you could say that there are going to be no x-intercepts. I spelled discriminant wrong. So what? That should work. So you can either look at the discriminant or you can just picture this. Y-intercept has to be 4 and it's opening upwards, so that's how that's going to roll. So those are the first four. Taking a look at the next bit, you're dissecting your answers based off of the quadratic formula which is given to you. Keep in mind, you should pretty much have this in your back pocket as negative b plus or minus square root b squared minus 4ac. So based off of, yeah, denominator 2a. So based off of the denominator, you know that 2a is going to be equal to 4. So your a coefficient has to be equal to 2. And again, this is just based off of the denominator. We can say this. So this allows us to eliminate a few answers. We can get rid of A, because your A coefficient's not 2. We can get rid of D, we can get rid of F. With that being said, we can also say that B, negative B, is going to be negative 7. So this implies that B has to be positive 7. So we can eliminate a few more answers. We can eliminate C, we can eliminate E. We can then take this further, and we're trying to now dissect what the C constant is going to be. So although answer B is going to make the most sense, we're putting in the constant. So we know that if B squared minus 4AC equals this term in here, 33. Well, you already know A, you already know B. If you plug in 49, which is 7 squared minus 4 times 2 times C, this is then rewritten to 49 minus 8c equals 33. Two-step equations from algebra 1. So negative 8ac is going to be equal to 33 minus 49, so negative 16. Eventually c equals positive 2. So when we go back to the final answer, we can put in that c is 2. Rewriting with terms of I, 5's prime, so just rewrite square root of 5, put I outside, move on with it. You're then going and plotting negative 7i, so this is just 0 in the real direction. So you could rewrite this as 0 minus 7i. So nowhere in the real direction, just down 7. The absolute value is just showing the distance. So really, if you're starting at the origin, you're just moving 7 spaces down. So this is it. Done. It's an easy one. We're plotting from the multiple choice. So this is saying we need to go to the left 3 units and then up 2. So this only option that makes sense would be A. We could then sketch out this triangle that looks like this. We moved over 3 units, we moved up 2, so the square root to find this distance right here is 2 squared plus 3 squared. So this is going to be the square root of 13. And we can write our answer as a radical, which is fine. Combining like terms, 3 minus 9 gets you negative 6. 8i minus 2i will then deduct 6. 8i minus 2i gets you 6i, so done. That's it. Now you should probably want to see the problem, right? Division's tricky, but you know your complex conjugate. You know that this takes the denominator and rewrites it. So we keep the real term positive of 9, but we now switch the complex term. So it should now be minus 2i. We multiply the top and the bottom by this. So use foiling or use box method. The denominator, when simplified, should be 81 minus 4i squared. The top part, if we foil this out, would be 63 minus 14i minus 45i plus 10i squared. If we clean this up a little bit, 10i squared is pretty much just going to deduct 10, so we could rewrite this as 53. So 63 minus this 10. These are like terms. I squared, I know, is negative 1. We can then combine our I terms, which is going to subtract 59. Our denominator could be rewritten as 81 plus 4 now. So if we rewrite that over here, it's 85. Make sure 59i is there. As two fractions, we could separate this to 53 over 85 minus 59 over 85i. So when they say they want the answer in A plus BI form, this is what they mean.